listening to you conduct the great C major symphony of Schubert or the C minor symphony of Brahms, one is struck by the absolute rightness of the tempi. Any hints on how you arrive at this rightness? Is it entirely a matter of musical instinct?
I wonder. In the old BBC days, I used to think that I was doing things differently. For instance, differently in the Albert Hall or Queen's Hall. And the balance and control people, as we used to call them then, studio managers, used to come and say, you're 2 seconds different from so-and-so. I don't know why it is. I think, of course, it is essential to know, well, it sounds silly to say that, to know the music, but I mean to know the inside of the music and the underneath of the music, as it were, thoroughly, before you try and get the tempo. Oh, and then perhaps another thing. Yes, this is perhaps helpful to others, that the first bar of many pieces is rather misleading as to the tempo of the whole. I think it's only when you get into the middle of a work that you really find exactly what the tempo ought to be. Actually, an example would be Beethoven's slow movements. If you try and do Beethoven's slow movements at the pace they look like, you will find very often that by the time you get to the end of the movement, you wish there was less of it. And there's no reason why you should wish there was less of a Beethoven movement. Mm. It is just that the thing must move. Richard Strauss said that there was practically no slow movement of Haydn and Mozart's that could not be conducted to in a bar. Now that's interesting.
Indeed.
When you think of something like the Mozart G minor. But he did that one, he did that two in a bar. He might give six the first bar or so, and then it would be two. Although it's slow for that. And another movement I think very easily taken too slowly is the slow movement of Schubert's number five in B flat. If you take that beginning at the pace it seems to want to go, the movement goes on forever, and I have heard that movement cut simply because it's been played much too slowly.
Yeah.
Now, if you take the alternative section, the middle section of that movement, you'll find that it will stand a much faster pace. And if you don't, well, you probably don't want to change much, if you change at all in between, if the main part of the movement could be taken at the same pace, it is perfectly charming like that too. Though it looks as if it might go a lot slower. There are some of the problems of pace, I think. It's a thing you cannot determine in a minute. I very often take months before I get settled in a pace like that. You change your mind and it keeps on being different. And it's quite a job, but it's worth getting it. And once you've got it, you don't need to have much change after that.